Blockchain. It's more than just a buzzword. This revolutionary technology has already disrupted numerous industries, and now it's making waves in the gaming world. With blockchain gaming, players can earn real-world currency while immersing themselves in fun virtual worlds. In this video, we will examine how blockchain games actually work and help you decide if they are just hype or the future of gaming. When it comes to blockchain games, there are a few models that companies can take. The first model is more of the metaverse model, which isn't purely based on play to earn, and has been taken by companies like Decentraland. Decentraland is free to play for everyone, and the game utilizes the blockchain in a number of different ways. The first is with its Ethereum governance token, Mana. Holding Mana allows you to participate in the Decentraland DAO, where users can shape the future of the game by creating and voting on proposals. Each Mana token gives the user one voting right, and the price of Mana is highly correlated to the success of the game. The other core blockchain-related aspect of Decentraland is its NFT capabilities. In Decentraland, virtual land plots and other in-game assets are almost entirely made up of non-fungible tokens, or NFTs. NFTs allow users to own the actual in-game item via blockchain technology and allow them to sell it in the marketplace for Mana. Even if you don't purchase an NFT to start, you can create your own and potentially earn Mana by selling it. Each plot of land or location within Decentraland is unique and created by an individual, making it similar to real estate owned within the real world. This metaverse model of blockchain gaming offers some play-to-earn opportunities, such as mini-games that reward players with NFTs which can be sold for profit in the marketplace. The core aspects of Decentraland is based on blockchain technology, but more specifically, NFTs. The core value proposition is not to earn, but rather to create, socialize, help improve the game, and own your digital assets in a fun way. Other blockchain-based games like Axie Infinity have their core value proposition based on the fact that users have the potential to earn profit, meaning people are interested in playing, primarily for the potential to earn. To start playing Axie Infinity, you need to buy a team of 3 NFTs called Axies, which were very expensive at the peak of the game. A team would cost you approximately $1,000 were the NFTs to be decent. However, a team of Axies can currently be purchased for around 10 bucks at this point in time. These Axies allow you to earn SLP, the game's native cryptocurrency. SLP can be sold on various decentralized cryptocurrency exchanges for other assets such as Ethereum or stablecoins. SLP is needed because it's essential for breeding or the creation of new axes, which was a core, and will add, very profitable aspect of the game. However, all of this came crashing down because this business model depends on new players joining the game, and with an oversupply of axes, the price for the NFTs dropped. Additionally, the price of SLP, the game's currency, is directly linked to the increase in demand for new axes, which is created by new players joining, and without them, the system isn't effective in helping people make money. To put it simply, supply outpaced demand, which caused the drop-off. At its peak, some people were even hiring others, especially in developing countries, to play Axie Infinity for them, in exchange for a percentage of the earned SLP, which was 5 times more profitable than traditional jobs in certain countries for some time. However, this is no longer the case, following the decline of new players joining the game. You may have heard the rumor that some Axie Infinity employees preferred to take payment in the form of SLP during the height of its value. But let's be real, creating a game that's both fun to play and profitable is no easy feat. We'll explain the challenges with play to earn in a moment, but if you found that joke somewhat funny, hit that like button. The other play to earn model, that also has a core value proposition of having the potential to earn profit, is based on a membership model. In this model, each player must pay a fee, let's say $10 per month, in order to participate in the opportunity to make money. At the end of each month, players that have accumulated the most XP, which could be by winning the most fights, are rewarded with the game's native cryptocurrency, which again can be sold on exchanges for other digital assets. With this model, the skilled players are the ones who are making the money and the bad ones are receiving monumentally less. The amount of the reward for the top players will depend on the price of the game's native cryptocurrency, which, like Axie Infinity, will likely be necessary for some essential task like breeding, or being able to purchase better equipment, that will allow you to perform even better next month. Some of these models have been improved upon by having burn mechanisms or algorithms to help the value of the native cryptocurrency remain relatively similar to the intended price. This helps ensure there isn't an enormous crash and that there are less people looking to take advantage of an arbitrage opportunity. There are some problems with this business model, as those who are paying for a higher membership, let's say $20 instead of $10, are able to receive more perks. Additionally, this makes the game more of a pay-to-win model, which could make the game less enjoyable and therefore unsustainable for new players. Other challenges with play-to-earn include the fact that people are partaking in the action solely with the intent of making money. These speculative players begin using strategies that the game's developers likely didn't intend for and look for any cracks in the system that may help them make money. Many have agreed that Axie Infinity isn't the most special game, and removing the play-to-earn aspect reduces the game's primary value proposition. Axie Infinity's parent company, Sky Mavis, recognizes the need for continuous improvement in order to enhance the game's overall enjoyment factor. However, one challenge with play-to-earn is that newer players often provide the financial influx, which poses sustainability issues, since every transaction involves a winner and a loser. That being said, games like Axie Infinity are taking steps in the right direction by allowing users to have full control or ownership over their assets. Giving more power to the players is undoubtedly a plus that comes with blockchain gaming, but more specifically, NFTs. If a company were to turn their servers off, but the assets from the game were NFTs, players would still have ownership and be able to resell the assets were there to be demand on third-party marketplaces like OpenSea. NFTs within gaming also pose the potential for interoperability, meaning users will have the ability to transfer an asset from one game to another. A seamless integration of an asset from one world to another provides immense value to users and increased flexibility. Utilizing other aspects of blockchain gaming, like governance tokens, which we will have a full video on shortly, allow for the community to help decide what's best for the game. Having assets built atop the blockchain, including NFTs, allows for a greater level of transparency, as everyone is able to see the amount of that asset that has been created. Transparency also increases when governance tokens are in play, as everyone can observe the governance process and changes made as they occur on the blockchain. This provides a higher level of trust. Taking a step back and looking at the existing blockchain games shows that we are at the very beginning stages of blockchain gaming, and only a seed has been planted. It has the potential to grow into something enormous. However, time and nourishment is needed before blockchain gaming will reach its full potential. All of these aspects, like true ownership of in-game items, community-driven development, and interoperability, amongst others, are just the early stages of blockchain gaming use cases. Let us know if you think we missed anything in the comments below, and we'd love to hear your thoughts on blockchain games. Are they just hype, or is it the future of gaming? If you enjoyed this video and found it informative, we would be absolutely delighted if you could help support our team by showing your appreciation through hitting the like and subscribe buttons. We truly value your engagement and look forward to sharing more high-quality content with you in the future. Be sure to explore our channel for additional informative and engaging content that we're confident you'll love.